Exciting news.
Oh, yeah?
That's right. We have acquired the rights to a certain character from a certain television show.
Oh.
The show is, you know, getting spin-offs and stuff, and one character has been noticeably omitted from all of the later iterations. That's right. I'm talking about Worf. We got Worf now.
All right.
Yes. They did Picard. They've done some movies. They've done some rebooting, some pre-booting. But according to the suits at Paramount, they said that a big guy with a ponytail in this day and age is, quote, a little too rapey for television. So he's ours now.
You know, no big deal. We can give him a new hairstyle. I'd like to see what Worf would look like with a bob.
Give him he's got a cute set of bangs.
This is definitely gonna, this ain't gonna be your daddy's Worf. This is gonna be a cute ass Worf.
We're gonna, yeah, it's gonna be like Zooey Deschanel. We're gonna give him a little cute cocktail dress, teach him to play the ukulele.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Where he's gonna have one of those classic Friends apartments. Do you think that we should, are we going to create all new, roommates for him? Or do you think that we can, get some other, roommates on the cheap from.
Get a Ross in there.
Yeah. Yeah. What's David Schwimmer doing? Hanging out with Worf. That's what.
Yeah. Captain, I am experiencing the worst day ever.
I don't know, really. We can probably get Chandler and Joey in there too. I think that the friend boys have not had the success that the friend girls have had.
We're just gonna spend all our money getting the cast of Friends,
yeah,
the male cast of Friends to get into the apartment with Worf, and then we won't have any money left over to pay writers.
I mean, they kind of write themselves. I mean, think about all of the hijinks that these guys are going to get into.
Oh, yeah. No, essentially, we would just end up with Big Brother.
Yeah. Well, if we can't afford those friends, maybe we get Gunther.
Oh, that's perfect. We get Worf and Gunther and that obnoxious guy from Becker.
Okay. Which one's the obnoxious guy from Becker?
He's like a little Guido, fast-talking guy. Oh, you know, okay. What I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah. Him.
You know, if in a perfect world where I had a time machine, I'd get Fred Mertz up in there.
Hmm.
It seems like he and Worf would be fast friends.
They both like high-waisted pants.
It's true.
So we got Worf, and we got to figure out something to do with him now.
Well, I mean, he's starting a new career kind of late in life.
I don't know why I bought Worf. I know I'm not going to use him. He's going to be down here in the basement with a bunch of laundry just draped over him like the treadmill. Spent all this money on a Worf.
Yeah.
I'm going to use him, I swear. I have so many ideas for this Worf.
I don't know. Maybe Worf is a hot yoga teacher. I think that could work.
That's, again... We have to be careful what kind of situations we put Worf in. The ponytail thing. Ugh.
Ooh, maybe
Maybe we open a ladies self-defense class and we just let for a small fee, you can just wail on Worf.
That would be fun. Maybe we set it in San Francisco and it can be Fisherman's Worf.
And he's on a boat.
Yeah.
There's no women around. Nobody to point fingers. Nobody to glare accusingly at Worf. He's out there on a boat with other men.
Yeah. I mean, Joey, if you're going after that,
all crab fishermen.
If you're going after that deadliest catch, you're going to want Worf on your side. He already
Captain,
knows all
my
the
last three paychecks bounced. I'm sorry, you were saying he already knows.
He already knows all the terminology, you know, starboard, because the USS Enterprise is not unlike a crab fishing boat.
Yeah. Except instead of crabs, it's the friends they made along the way. Here they are. Quark. Q. That goopy oil puddle that kills Tasha Yar. But we don't have the rights to any of that. All we got is Worf. We can do whatever we want with Worf, but we can't bring anybody else in the mix. So
are you saying that
maybe
that
we do like a,
we're going to have to do like a Worf one man show.
Yeah. He can't talk about Star Trek. He can't reference any characters, any other intellectual properties. He has to be a completely self-contained thing now. All we have the rights to is Worf, and we don't have any like Worf stories. We could maybe get away with like him referencing a thing that happened to him as long as he doesn't bring up anyone else who was in that episode or that plot line from Star Trek.
Okay.
So it could be like, one time I had to fight someone. He can't say who he fought.
Mm-hmm.
They were from another place.
Well, I'm excited. I think that I always wanted to see more of Worf in a relationship. I think we could maybe do like a family style sitcom, love, like a Last Klingon Standing, if you will.
Hang on, I'm trying to get a read on whether or not my voice is recording. I'm not seeing any. Can you see?
I am seeing little bumps on yours, but not on my end.
Oh, okay. I'm seeing bumps on yours, but not on mine. So I guess it's just
okay.
A bug. Whew. Okay. I've forgotten where we were.
We were talking about Worf.
Oh, that's right.
He's a very dynamic character. I think that there is no end to the possibilities of what we can do with Worf.
We just drop him into a completely different situation like Frasier. That's kind of what I think we need to do. Now Worf is a teacher and he has a brother who's just like him. Also, Worf is way more effeminate and fancy than he was on Star Trek.
Awesome.
And he lives with his dad, who's an ex-cop. Who loves his old chair.
Now, is Worf's dad a Klingon, or was Worf adopted?
We just steal as much as we can from Frasier before we get sued. We're like, what? We didn't take anything from Worf's old show. He's in love with the housekeeper.
Who do you think would be the Niles to Worf? David Hyde Pierce, maybe?
Just get David Hyde Pierce back in there. Give him a bumpy head.
Yeah.
I was going to say that guy from the Make 7 Up Yours commercial.
Oh. Orlando Jones, I think.
Orlando Jones, yes. I was going to say, not Godfrey, the original Make Seven Up Yours guy.
Yeah, he had a real moment. I am now kind of interested to look up what happened to him.
Mm-mm-mm. He was in that movie, that dumb alien movie with David Duchovny.
The
Evolution.
Yeah, and Ivan Reitman joint trying to recapture that Ghostbusters magic.
What a stinker! I remember I saw that movie in the theater, and they were like, "We figured it out. We looked at the periodic table of elements and." Cyanide, isn't that what it is poisonous to humans, and since that's one different from, since they're silicon and it's one different from carbon on the periodic table, we just said, what if we went one different on cyanide, and that's selenium, and so we thought maybe that'll poison them, and that's the stuff that's in Head and Shoulders. And I was like, no, it's not, that's the secret ingredient in Celsin Blue, you got the wrong dandruff shampoo.
Took you right out of the film. Ruined it.
I was just sitting there like, I want to point this out, but then I would have to tell people that I use dandruff shampoo.
But I mean, come on. The first three letters of the element and the first three letters of the shampoo are the same. It's a dead giveaway.
Yeah. Boy, serious blunder.
Yeah.
I want to go on IMDb and make sure that somebody has pointed that out. Because. Phew. All right, I got an idea for a podcast. All right, here.
Lay it on me.
This is called How the Sausage Gets Made.
Ooh.
I'm sure you've heard that old saying.
Yep. And I've had sausage. Don't know
how the sausage gets made. Well, I had the idea for this because I've been getting into making my own sausage.
Ooh.
I'm getting pretty good at it, too. I can make like a sweet Italian. I made like a smoked country breakfast patty the other day. I was like, man, I miss going to the Cracker Barrel.
Yeah.
I missed it enough to try and make Cracker Barrel sausage at my house.
What spice profile are you using? I know they usually use sage in it, but that's about as far as my knowledge goes.
The trick to a good breakfast sausage is marjoram. Marjoram gives it that delicious breakfast. Yeah, that the sage, your fennel.
Ooh,
that's a good. I got a mortar and pestle too. I'm going hog wild on my spices. I have a list, a grocery list, and Lara went out to the grocery store a little bit ago, and she's like, "Okay, I'm looking at the stuff on the list. Tell me if there's anything I'm forgetting." It says black mustard seed. I was like, "Don't even bother. Don't even bother fucking looking for that at Kroger's." I know I'm going to have to go somewhere special for that one.
You need a spice guy.
The spice must flow.
Oh,
you
man.
Excited for that, Dune?
Yeah, I am. And I think it'd be a pretty sweet idea that the Dune swag should be just like a Dune spice rack with a lot of different spices.
What if we made a little sausage that looked like the Shai Hulud?
Yeah.
Like the sandworm coming up out of the dirt. But he's got a little twisted cartoon hot dog end. I haven't done a sausage with a casing yet.
That was going to be my next question, because where would you buy sausage casings?
You have to get it. You have to special order it. And I mean, or you can butcher an animal and clean its intestine.
Yeah. Make some of your own condoms along the way.
Yeah. I got married and I just have a big box of condoms that are just lying fallow now. Maybe I just use those. Gonna have people over for bratwursts. Oh, these are good. Thank you. They're Lifestyles brand sausage.
Yeah, you got to be careful though. If you squeeze too hard, you'll shoot that whole sausage down your throat. It's slippery. Mm.
And then you're going out. You're running down to the Walgreens and spend a bunch of money on the Plan B bun.
Do you think if you had a strong enough sausage casing, you could make sausage animals like a clown does with balloons?
Ooh, yeah.
Would that Look just be dog. Too insulting to then make an approximation of the animal that you use to make your sausage with?
It might be, yeah. Unless you had giraffe sausage, then people would be like, damn, okay. All right.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
All right, do you have an idea for a podcast?
Yeah, this one is called Corporate Trust Building Podcast, which, you know how a lot of businesses, they'll have a bowling team or a softball team, or they'll go to an escape room or something. I think that we could, you know, rent out our studio space and walk people through, and they would definitely grow as a business unit by doing a podcast together.
Yeah. So,
and then we could do a secret second podcast where we make fun of them after the fact.
Oh, I like that, because I was going to say, I've done a couple of those, and sometimes they're fun, sometimes they are the pits. But they all usually include some sort of like ropes course or, you know, an escape room. I'm just wondering, what are we going to do? How are we going to?
I don't know. Maybe we make them battle Worf.
Yes! Finally, a use for Worf.
You know, it's just for now, Worf. We're still working on your big TV project, but right now, you're going to fight all these business people. Gonna dress you up like Nitro from American Gladiators, get you up on the tall podium, and you're gonna knock a bunch of idiots on their asses.
Now, to be clear, we own the rights to Worf, the character. We do not own Michael Dorn. So, if we can't get him on board with the project, we can recast Worf. We can make this a Worf for a new generation.
Maybe it's but young Worf. I think
it's really stretching it if we just have, you know.
That's the new trend. I mean, young Sheldon, we got young Rock coming. Young Worf.
Young Rock?
Yeah, it's, they're making a sitcom about Dwayne the Rock Johnson's youth.
What?
I've been seeing a lot of ads the past week for it.
Oh my god. What?
Do you need a moment to process this information?
I need a moment. The young Rock. Does he also have autism? Is that how it works?
I don't think he does, like, and I feel...
Excuse me, I believe wrestling is fake. It's just his whole wrestling family calling him a gay wad and throwing him in the dumpster. The young Rock. What?
But maybe that's a bad idea to do young Worf, because I am expecting him to battle fully grown business managers. So that might not be
maybe
fair.
Maybe what we do is this is like a corporate team building exercise. And they think that they're going to show up and it'll be like, all right, now you're doing a zip line. But instead, like we put them in like a room with a bunch of black lights and put laser tag get up on them. And then we're like, all right, now, everybody, we want to go over some rules about safety. Do not hit anyone over the head. If your vest starts to light up, then you just wait and until it powers back on. And when the lights come on, everybody head for the exit. Do you understand? Thank you. And then you open the door, they walk through it. There's like a fog machine. They walk through the door and then the fog clears and they're just in an office building and Worf is there. It's like, why aren't you at your cubicle? Get to work. We just have Worf and he's a terrible boss. He's very overbearing. And at the end of the day, everybody is just thankful that they don't have to work for Worf in real life. You go back to your job at your office and you're like, well, I mean, Rick is a definite dickhead, but
yeah,
he's no Worf.
I'm starting to, I thought I wanted Rick to stop making sexist jokes in the office, but Worf is completely humorless. This is much better.
Corporate trust building podcast. I think that there's potential here. I think that I wonder how many people we could get in one recording session. We've never tested the limits of what software can do, but I think it would definitely have to be a small business. We can't get but it might be something.
I don't know. We might be able to get them to break down into teams of four, and then we let the free market decide who had the most successful podcast. That's where the competition is.
Yeah. All right, I got an idea here.
Okay.
This one might sound familiar at first, but it's a twist on a classic. This is called Would You Rather Not?
Ooh.
So this is like, you know, when people play Would You Rather? This is Would You Rather Not?
So in this scenario, would we be offering two very good options that people would want to do both and they have to eliminate one instead of it
right
being
you have to decide which one of two good options you don't want to do.
Okay.
So you could be like, would you rather not go to the mall with me or have 3 more presents on Christmas.
I'm a lover of presents. It's nothing against you. I'm sure you are a fun mall buddy. I bet you go to both the Orange Julius and the Auntie Anne's.
Oh, I'm gonna try on everything at Sunglass Hut
and buy nothing.
I just walk around with those sunglasses on. What do you think? I talk to everybody that works there. What do you think? Trying on all the most expensive sunglasses. They're bringing me other stuff. I'm like, yeah, hell yeah. Look at me. Who do I look like? Wrong. And then I just put them all down and walk out. Everybody's got blue sale balls. Nobody sold me any expensive sunglasses. Well, that's where you're wrong, because the 3 presents were gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
I mean, the gold. I mean, the gold makes up for the shitty ones.
It's the record by Neil Diamond. It's not not the precious metal.
What songs are on that one?
Sweet Caroline, Kentucky Woman, Holy Holy, Lordy, Both Sides Now, Brother Love's Traveling Salvation Show. Thank the Lord for the nighttime.
Okay. That, I don't feel too bad. Maybe the mall would have been more fun, but I think that I'll get some use out of gold.
We were going to bring Worf to the mall.
Oh, you can't take Worf to the mall.
We were going to take Worf to the mall and do jackass pranks.
Now, that does sound great, but I think that we would need to do this on video. I don't think this could be a podcast. I don't think we can do a Worf Mime podcast.
Mm. We can just describe what Worf is doing.
Oh, can we do it in the style of golf announcers where, you know, we're going to do it in a whisper because...
All right, now Worf is approaching the Orange Julius and he's bent over and his Starfleet pants have split open and his Klingon balls have spilled out. Oh. Several people are looking and then looking around to see if anyone else has noticed. Oh, and an older woman has reached out and tickled his ball. This is the thing. We could get away with a lot more if we're just narrating it than we would doing it the... doing it the traditional way of actually capturing it, you know.
Yeah,
we can take a little bit of poetic license with what happened. Oh my god, yeah, he took a shopping cart and he rode it down the hill and he crashed it into the curb and he flew out of it, folks, and now he is sailing through the air and now he's gone in the window of a passing truck and now he's stuck on the lap of the truck driver and the truck driver is refusing to stop. He says he's got to make it to Texarkana, Texas in less than 48 hours.
Interesting. I wonder now, if Worf will go for cash, grass, or ass in this transaction.
And the truck driver is tickling Worf's balls. Looks like no one rides for free. That was Would You Rather Not?
Yes. And my next idea is also sort of a, could be a choice kind of podcast. It's called Roy's and Burls.
Roy's and Burls.
Yeah. Which it's going to be kind of a Roy Orbison versus Burl Ives kind of podcast.
Oh, so this would be like Roy's versus Burls.
Yes. Yeah. Who you got?
Okay.
Or maybe it's they just share the stage. I'm not really sure on this one.
Roy's and Burls. Roy's versus Burls. Whoever wins, we win.
Yeah. Everybody wins.
It's the opposite of Alien versus Predator here.
Yeah. Also, possibly it's a different Roy and a different Burl each week. I mean, we're going to run out of both really fast, but...
I was like, well, we can do the rooster from U.S. Acres. And I guess like a very knotted piece of hardwood. that's what we're working with.
Yeah, this started when I heard a Roy Orbison song and I started trying to think of other Roys and I'm like, I got Roy Lichtenstein, L. Roy Jetson, and then I was out. And then I thought that it was just the rhyming thing. I'm no Burl Ives expert.
Uh-huh. Wait, is Roy Orbison a Burl Ives expert?
I would imagine so. I mean, it's you know, kind of hard to find out
too
now.
Too late to ask.
Maybe
now,
we could dig him up and see if he was buried with his Burl Ives memorabilia.
We could perhaps take every known interview conducted with Roy Orbison and feed that to the Podtron.
Bring
Roy Orbison back to life. Ooh. Through the magic of artificial intelligence.
That could be awesome. People loved what they did with Vince Lombardi at the Super Bowl. So I think that we could maybe do something similar.
What did they do with Vince Lombardi at the Super Bowl?
They made like a computer-generated Vince Lombardi, and he gave like a rah-rah speech right before the game started. It was very Tupac at Coachella, but Vince Lombardi.
So wait, it was like the hologram of Robert Kardashian saying that he was
kind of yeah.
He was so excited about what a genius Kanye West.
Yeah,
is.
Yeah. Lombardi did talk a lot about Kanye during his rah-rah speech.
He was like the most genius person to ever watch football, Kanye West. And whoever wins out there, when they make a big peefee. This is an entire paradigm that we could be getting into here. Bringing someone back to life using our artificial intelligence.
Mm-hmm. And maybe that's maybe it's a talk show where we interview
Roy's and Burls.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or maybe it's Roy's on Burls.
Okay.
Like you have a Roy Orbison talk about Burl Ives, and that would be.
I thought you meant to just like stack them up high.
Some hot Burl on Burl action.
We got young Burl and old Burl.
We could throw Thurl in there,
like
Thurl Ravenscroft,
mm-hmm. Former
they're great
NBA player Thurl Bailey.
Yeah. Ooh, look at that! We already got two Thurls. We can't think
that's
of another
one
Burl.
More Burl than we have.
They're more Thurl than Burl.
Okay, maybe
now.
Maybe it's Roy's and
Ruthless
Thurls.
Ruthless and cruel. Roy's and Thurls. All right. Well, let's go to the hotline. What do you say?
I say yay.
Yay for the hotline. Oh, but it's going to take a second because I didn't load the thing ahead of time. Oh, it's not going to work at all. Isn't this great?
No, it's not. I need my hotline.
I don't know. I fucked it up. No sound effects this week. Folks, if you have an idea for a podcast, you can always... call the podcast hotline. That's 702-PODCASP, 702-PODCASP. Or you can drop us a line at wedonthaveapodcastyet@gmail.com. We'd love to hear from you. We love all of the great ideas that people send us, like this week from Annette, who writes, job interview. Parentheses. A podcast where you interview the guy from the Bible.
So
this is Job interview. Okay. This could be good. He seems like he's had a rough time. Definitely an interesting, you know, this isn't going to be some sort of a puff piece, you know. You're not going to be like, so what's it like being the happiest man in the world?
No,
this is going to be a rough one. It's going to be a story of heartache.
Well, he's such a like, trooper, though. Like, I mean, his faith never wavers. I don't think he's going to ask for a lot of pity or anything.
Yeah. Do you think if Job were alive today, do you think he would get on? He'd go live on the gram and just be like just doing a kind of a very negative woe is me. Bullshit.
I think he'd probably be do like a TikTok.
He did
dancer.
Like, he would like, you know, he did like sit around in ashes and like tear his clothes and wear sackcloth and like gnash his teeth and shit. Kind of like a Bible Times Bam Margera.
Yeah.
Now God says I can't be in the Bible part four. Fuck him.
And I do think it's time for a teeth gnashing to make its way back around again. I don't think people have been gnashing a lot lately.
Last person I could think of was King Jeremy the Wicked, also from the Bible. Of course, he didn't just gnash his teeth. Maybe that's what Job was missing. There weren't any recess ladies nearby. Just gnashing his teeth. Never got around to the second part.
One weird thing about that, back then, you know, teeth didn't last that long. You had to get that gnashing in when you were young.
You get two, three good gnashes, you're down to the little stubby nubs.
Mm-hmm.
You're in ancient Egypt.
It's going to be eating a lot of porridge, probably. Did they have porridge yet?
I don't know. Just probably breast milk, right? From the recess lady. Yeah, I think porridge wasn't invented until, like, it wasn't in Bible times. They had, like stews, right? Esau got tricked out of his birthright for a hearty stew. But I'm pretty sure that porridge didn't get invented until the Goldilocks times.
Ah, like,
that's New Testament.
Yeah, that's much later. I mean, the biblical bears weren't building their own homes yet.
You had the parable of the three little pigs.
Yeah, pig. I still don't know how they did it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I can see a bear holding a hammer, you know. I can see a bear architect. I can't see a pig architect.
Mm-hmm. And then you had St. Paul's epistle to the planet Cybertron, to the first and second Decepticons.
Yeah, the Transformers built the pyramids.
It all comes back around. All right, well, let's go to the Podtron now.
Okay.
Folks, if you're not familiar with our program, we don't just come up with audience ideas and our own ideas. We also build an artificial intelligence that comes up with ideas for us. And that artificial intelligence is known as the Podtron 4500. Ooh, I almost upgraded him. What we did is we took a artificial intelligence and we gave it the iTunes podcast charts. And then it tries to synthesize that into the names of podcasts that might also be successful. Ideas like Danger NBA.
Awesome.
Was that
you? That was going to be my. Yeah, absolutely it was.
Oh, no.
What,
all right. Well,
I'll
count
pick
that
a
as
one.
Yours then.
No, I'll pick a different one.
I wrote down three. So we can do Danger NBA, and I'll use one of my other ones.
Okay. Well, what do you think Danger NBA is? I was thinking it could possibly be a retrospective on Slam Ball. Do you remember Slam Ball? It was a television program where frequently it was college basketball players who were not good enough to get into the NBA, but they had a basketball court that had trampolines on it.
Oh, this was like, when was this?
I think it was probably, I'm going to guess like 2000 through 2003.
So this was before the... not good enough to go into the NBA to Eastern Europe pipeline opened up.
It was kind of there, but Slam Ball was in the good old US of A. You didn't have to.
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of what I was thinking, is like Legends of the Hidden Temple meets basketball. Maybe more of like a Wipeout, like an obstacle course.
Mm-hmm.
Like American Gladiators. This would be a perfect opportunity to inject a little Worf into the game, you know?
I concur. I think that Worf would be an amazing Danger NBA player.
Yeah. Well, no, he'd be one of the stalkers.
Ah.
This would be part of our Running Man motif.
Okay.
We give him a big sequin flame jumpsuit and a blowtorch, and he just gets to go out there and try and maim people on the court of the Danger NBA.
Maybe part of it is a heavy ball. You know, maybe we use a medicine ball. Maybe we use a metal ball.
Mm. Maybe you can unlock multiple metal balls.
Ooh, multi-ball.
You get like a multiplier and then more balls start coming out. Oh, and what's this? The old lady is tickling the balls. She's back again. She loves it, folks. We could also... I just realized we're going to get sued if we use NBA, though, right? It's WWF all over again.
Yeah, that's true.
What we could potentially do is make ours somehow about like preserving endangered animals so that we win the lawsuit. Maybe we put like a sloth on the logo.
Ooh.
And then when we go to court, we're like, what do these guys have? Well, a bunch of overpaid crybabies falling down and acting like they got hurt, or us? And then we have a sloth, and then we like surprise the judge with a sloth, like one of those viral videos. The judge is like, oh, a sloth, look at him. And the sloth's climbing all over the judge, and we're like, yeah, judge. Now, who should be the NBA?
I'm trying to figure out which one of these letters we're going to make into sloth somehow.
Well, I'd say we just call it the Nature Ball Association.
Oh.
Or maybe the Nature...
Now, this sloth is going to be an ironic mascot, yes, because this is going to be a very fast-paced game.
Well, yeah. He just represents how we want this case to go through the courts. We want it to be a long, protracted thing. It has nothing to do with the sport. You're like, what's the sloth for? Oh, he's our mascot. That's Draggy. That's Draggy the sloth. He drags out court cases. Yeah.
He's also our head counsel.
And then he has the rule book on if sloths can be lawyers. And he's like, well, the judge is like, does it say a sloth can be a lawyer? Well, there's the judge dies of old age before we ever find out if there's anything in the rule book that says a sloth can be a lawyer.
I mean, I think that they
it's
should
the
let
perfect crime.
I think we should have a lot more sloth senators. Can you imagine those guys doing a filibuster? They wouldn't even have. They wouldn't be breaking a sweat. It'd be business as usual.
It would just be like I would. Like to do a filibuster. It's like been a week. All they've done is say, I would like to do a filibuster. Danger, NBA.
Yeah.
I've got one here.
Okay.
This is called Travision.
Travision. Like Travis T-R-A. Ion.
Travis Ion. Travision.
Okay.
Now I know that there's a popular television show called WandaVision. Have you heard about this?
I've heard about the WandaVision.
Have you seen this? Have you heard about this?
I've heard about this.
What WandaVision is they took the two most underdeveloped characters from the Avengers and they said, what if we made a show about that and expected you to give a fuck?
I think that's pretty accurate as to what they have done.
I don't know what WandaVision is.
I think that the conceit of the show is that each episode is a different decade sitcom. I think when it starts out, it's like I Love Lucy, and then it goes 60s episode, 70s episode, 80s episode.
Sounds great.
Yeah.
Can't wait to hear about it. But I will never watch it. You could tell me I watched that WandaVision show and Nathan, you are in it. And all the characters suck your dick. I'd be like, still not watching it. I don't care.
All right. Well,
all those characters can suck my dick.
Wait, what if I told you that Worf's in it?
Oh, well, then you are going to have to talk to our sloth lawyer.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that you will find that you do not have the rights to use Worf in WandaVision.
So this would be maybe what we do. We give them a little taste of their own medicine. We make a show called Travision. And this is where, I mean, maybe we just go through, we run the gamut of Travises every week. Worf has to play a different Travis. One, he's Travis Bickle.
Now, are we going to keep Vision from the MCU in it? It's just Paul Bettany in a nonstop string of different Travises.
It's not Travis and Vision. It's Travision. It's like a quantum leap thing where every week Worf wakes up and he sees himself in the mirror. That's the Vision part. Mm-hmm. He looks in the mirror. Oh, he's like, oh my God, I'm Travis Scott now. I've woken up again. I'm Travie McCoy from the Gym Class Heroes. I briefly dated Katie. What's her name?
I'm not sure. My Travis knowledge runs more to the 90s country Travises. Your Randy's and Tritt.
Yeah. Boy, I'm really stuck on who that is, that pop star.
You said Katie?
One of the famous ones.
Katy Perry?
Katy Perry, yeah.
Okay.
Damn it!
The ex Mrs. Russell Brand.
She also dated this dude from a Christian punk band called Reliant K back in the day. That was a long time
ago. There a lot of Christian punk bands?
Oh, yes. There are quite a few. We could do a whole episode just about Christian punk music.
In my hometown, there was a Christian punk pizza place.
What?
There's a pizza restaurant that would have Christian punk shows at it. It did not last very long.
Oh. I thought that somehow the pizza was Christian punk.
I mean, it was.
Did they have like funny names for the pizzas?
Probably. I think I only went one time. I wasn't a Christian punk.
What was the name of the band?
It wasn't a punk band. It was a Denova Doll.
I never heard of them.
They were an indie band.
Well, it must have been a little too indie, because I never heard of them.
I mean, they did play at a Christian punk pizza place.
A Christian pizzeria.
In a small town, so.
They have, like... They have, like, the robot band, like, in Chuck E. Cheese.
The Rock-a-Fire Explosion.
But they're, it's Jesus and the Apostles. Got Judas blowing on the jug.
Ooh. I mean, didn't the Chuck E. Cheese's close down? I mean, those robots have been repurposed once. Who says they can't be done again?
We're gonna start a cult and have the Chuck E. Cheese robots lead our praise and worship band.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. These are gonna be some like Christian Worf. Punk robot rats.
We have a ska band, and it's just a sloth and eight robot Worfs.
Yeah.
All right, give me another idea from the Podron.
Okay, this is MacOS Kevin.
MacOS Kevin.
Yeah.
So this is kind of like an iCarly, huh?
Somewhat, yes. It's
But this is the desktop software, not the iCarly only ran on phones and mobile devices.
I was kind of thinking that this was the Podtron trying to give us a message, like that, hey guys, I need a friend.
MacOS Kevin. We would create another artificial intelligence to be friends with the Podtron. And then maybe the two of them just have a podcast and we sit this one out. Just let MacOS Kevin and Podtron 4500 do a show and we don't have to do anything.
Yeah, we can just sit on our hands.
It's interesting.
Why is that a phrase? Do people actually ever sit on their hands? You're kind of doing it right now, actually.
I am sitting on my hands right now. You can see me in the chat.
All right.
I was like, yeah, people do that sometimes. Sometimes when people love each other very much. MacOS Kevin. Now, I think we need to come up with some parameters for Kevin. I mean, clearly he's a Mac user.
Mm-hmm.
He, favorite food? Tacos.
Okay. Now, do you think that this is just your, do you think it's a basic taco or do you think he's a fancy taco lover?
I think he likes to think that he knows where the best taco in town is.
Oh, he's one of those guys, huh?
Mm-hmm. The more that, I mean, we're not that far in, but it does kind of feel like MacOS Kevin is making a dating profile just based on what we've created so far. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe we let the Podtron go out into the real world and try and find someone.
Ooh.
We let Podtron create a dating profile. it wouldn't be the first time that we have ventured into this. We once did a live stage show called Win a Date with AJ Estes, where AJ had to go on a date with someone from Tinder on stage.
Yeah.
It was a good one.
Yeah, it was terrifying. I had a great time. It went a lot better than I thought it would.
MacOS Kevin. Yeah, we could just let the artificial intelligence create a person. It gets to choose all the answers to all the questions on a dating profile. And then we see if we can't get somebody to fall in love, just catfish somebody with a podcast robot.
I like this idea a whole lot. It might not be the nicest thing we've ever done.
All right, I got one last one here from the Podtron.
Okay.
This is called the Chuck Project.
Ooh.
Now I didn't think to look and make sure that this isn't an actual podcast. It might very well have been just a real pod. I mean, the Chuck Project. There is something called the Chuck Program. But the Chuck Project. That's all me.
Okay. Maybe we Chuck listen Project. To the Chuck program and just ape it for the yeah. Chuck Project.
Maybe we just we can just review the Chuck program. The Chuck the Chuck program. Which one are we? We're the project. Yeah. So we can listen to the other there's when I search the Chuck Project, the first thing that comes up is a podcast called Whoop Podcast. So maybe we could do something with that too. Just something to think about. Maybe the Chuck Project is we check the Chuck Podcast and we remix it.
Okay. And
chop and screw it.
I'm thinking when I'm hearing Chuck, I'm thinking a nickname for Charles, but it could also be some ground Chuck. Maybe there'd be like a little crossover with our sausage podcast.
Mm-hmm. Or maybe that that show where the guy was like a spy, but he was like
a nerd. He worked at like a Best Buy.
Yeah, it's like that. You know, I heard that guy, that character, was the inspiration for Reddit. They were like, what if a bunch of these guys just all hung out on the internet?
It was kind of an if you build it, they will come sort of scenario.
Yeah. Kevin Costner is just out there, just sitting in front of his MacBook, like learning a code. He sees Chuck was canceled on TV and he's like, damn. And then he hears that whispering voice. Side for Chuck and his friends. What was that? Come on, make a website for Chuck and his friends. They want to catch the Boston Marathon bomber. The Chuck Project. All right, well, that's enough. Here's what we got this week. We got How the Sausage Gets Made, Corporate Trust Building Podcast, Would You Rather Not, Roy's and Burls, Job Interview, Danger NBA, Travision, MacOS Kevin, or The Chuck Project.
I'm kind of interested in the how the sausage gets made. I don't know if that's the easiest one for us to do, but do you have any preference this week?
I like Job Interview. But I also like the sausage one. I have been making some sausage. And we could learn a lot about sausage.
That's true. And I'm fine with Job Interview as well. I'm gonna sit back and let you make the call on this one.
Let's that's a toughie. Let's do the Job Interview.
Okay.
All right. Folks, if you want to hear Job Interview, you can head over to patreon.com/we don't have a podcast yet. That's where we keep the vault. That's a repository of every idea that we try. We try one a week. And if you sign up to support us, you'll get a extra helping of We Don't Have a Podcast Yet every week, every Friday or sometimes Saturday if our schedules get messed up. Or one of us is just watching a lot of 911 and not editing the podcast. That's where you'll get a second helping every week, as well as access to every past episode we've done. There's lots there. We have one where we made a bracketed tournament of animals and who would win in a fight. And it took us 2 days of recording. That one's actually a video you can watch, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a whole video up. Animal Fantasy Battle Tournament. Anyway, you can get all of those and more every week if you sign up to support us on Patreon.com. And also, if you have an idea for a podcast or you have something you want to say to us, you can reach out to the podcast hotline, 702-PODCSP, or our email address, wedonthaveapodcastyet@gmail.com. Follow us on Instagram, and that's it. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. We're Chester Cathedral.